So, Ansika, now we are live, so you can start our session.
But it's not showing that we are live.
What?
It's not showing on the side of the this, screen that we are
No,
live.
No, it is only visual to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I think one or two people should get connected so I can start by saying to them.
No, we have also more than 5-6 connections, so you can start because it is visual to only me how many persons are connected.
Okay. So hello everyone, this is Anshika, and I think it's 2:31. We should wait for the 2 minutes for all the candidates who would like to join us. We should wait for the 2 minutes and we will then start the session from 2:33 onwards. We will start the session. So any one of the guys who would like to ask their questions related to the today's topic, they can ask their question in the comment section. And we will try to take all the questions on behalf of yourself. We will ask the question from Mr. Mansoor Ahmed sir, who is our guest of the honor for this webinar. So put your questions in the comment section. We will try to take all the common questions from the comment section. Rohan, I'm also not visible to see the comments, if there is any comment from the student side or the people who are getting connected.
Actually, Ansika, your voice is again breaking, so I will continue this session. And okay. I think I am totally audible. My voice is okay to all of you?
Yes.
Please comment. Yeah. Okay. So, hi, everyone. My name is CMA Rohan Sharma, and today we are here with Mansoor Ahmed sir. He is live from London and he is connected with us. So we will discuss today about a scope of CMA in Europe. So first of all, I want to introduce Mansoor Ahmed sir and his qualification, his achievements during his journey. Mansoor Ahmed sir, he is a BCom graduate, MCom, and he is a fellow member of CM Institute, CIPF Institute, MCSI Institute, FFP Institute, and various other professional body. He is a fellow member. And about his achievements, so he get various recognition, like he got in last year British got he get la last year award from British government for citizenship award, and also he is the first Bangladeshi who got this award, and he came England from Bangladesh in 2007. So it is just a summary about him. There is lots of other things. He is very motivational person to us because he have a lots of qualification, lots of achievement, lots of experience. So it will help us if we want to decide our journey, we want to go somewhere else like that, then it will definitely help to us. So thank you, sir, for coming here and give us time and guide us and guiding us, because you have lots of experience and your experience will help to us.
Thank you, Mr. Rohan Sharma. Dear CMA India member.
Welcome, sir.
Students and my dear viewers, peace and blessings of God be upon you all. It is an immense pleasure for me. And first of all, take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks and gratitude to Mr. Rohan Sharma, CMA, and his professional mate, Ms. Anshika Tegin, CMA, for inviting me to this YouTube channel for discussing on the scope of CMA India in Europe. I will be discussing this topic into 3 parts. My first part will be CMA India and its recognition. In my second part, I'll be discussing MOUs with CMA India. And at the last part, we'll be discussing some question answers, the questions which we have received. The Institute of Cost Accountants of India is the largest CMA body in Asia and second largest body in the world, which has since been continuously contributing to the growth of the industrial and economic climate of India. In today's competitive world, the profession of conventional accounting and auditing has taken a back seat, and cost and management accountants progressively contributing towards the management of scarce resources like funds, land, and supply of strategic decision. This has undoubtedly opened up further scope and fantastic opportunities for cost accountants in India and abroad. The CMA is highly valued by employers in Europe and around the world. When your expertise is internationally certified, there are no borders on your career journey. And this has definitely a bright scope in Europe. Over the last few years, the most important, the importance of CMA has been on the rise. Dear CMA students, today I am going to discuss such an important issue which would undoubtedly make our talented CMAs happy. This is regarding the international scope and opportunities for CMA students. Yes, now it has become easier for Indian CMAs to obtain a job in Europe and other parts in the world. No doubt, our CMAs are brilliant and they are capable enough to deal with the situation. We believe that we have lots of knowledge, but this knowledge and qualification needs to be recognized by internationally recognized body. CMA India's syllabus and qualification has fortunately been recognized by UK ENIC. UK ENIC is United Kingdom's qualification recognition agency. It is a government agency to recognize the qualification with the objective of enhancing the recognition and professional opportunities for its students and members across the globe. The International Affairs Committee and Professional Development and CPD Committee of CMA India had engaged UK ENIC. UK ENIC is the UK National Information Centre for Global Qualifications and Skills to conduct an independent benchmarking study for evaluating the comparability of the CMA intermediate and final course in the context of UK and UAE education systems. UK ENIC is the designated national agency in the United Kingdom for the recognition of international qualifications and professional skills. As the national agency managed on behalf of UK government, UK ENIC is the international respected voice in qualification recognition, offering impartial trusted judgment on international qualifications. UK ENIC has the largest database of international qualifications in the world, with over 5,000 qualifications from more than 200 countries. UK ENIC is the UK National Information Centre for Global Qualifications and Skills. Following the UK's leaving the UK, the European Union, from 1st January 2021, the former UK NARIC recognition agency function changes from a NARIC which is an EU-only title, to an ENIC, the wider European title for national recognition agencies, in order to meet the UK's continuing treaty obligations under the Lisbon Recognition Convention. And ENIC is world's renowned agency for qualification recognition. It has now become easier to get a job in UK and other European countries. Here, the most important thing is that CMA intermediate course is recognized as bachelor's degree standard. And CMA final course is recognized as master's degree standard. This is indeed a great message for all our dear CMA students, undoubtedly. Interested CMAs and students can easily get their qualification recognized by obtaining statement of comparability. They need to upload CMA documents along with other required all details with www.enic.org.uk. Once the required documents are uploaded, ENIC will check these, and after verifying, if they are found okay, then the ENIC would send the statement of comparability at the applicant's home address. Applicants need to pay some fees in this regard. I have mentioned in my slides. Applicants need to show the statement of comparability to the employers in UK, other European countries, and UAE in order to get a job. Now I am coming to discuss the second part of my discussion. It is MOU, which CMA India signed with different financial bodies and professional bodies. CIPFA, UK, the Chartered Institute of Public Finance and Accountancy, CIPFA, is the only professional body in the world exclusively dedicated to public finance. CIPFA and CMA India entered into MOU on 25th January 2017 at London to strengthen public financial management capacity in India. One of the important aspects of this MOU from the viewpoint of CMA member is developing public sector training and membership. CMA members who have 5 or more years of experience working in or with public sector would be offered dual designation, full CIPFA membership in accordance with CIPFA's bylaw conditions. CIPFA will offer affiliate membership for all CMA members with a fast-track approach to full CIPFA membership. CMA members can easily build on existing memberships by adding CIPFA to the professional recognition and easily gain additional services to support work in the public services. CMA India members are entitled to exemptions towards becoming a full member of CIPFA. Then I'm coming to ACCA UK. The Association of Chartered Certified Accountants, ACCA, is the world's most forwarding thinking professional accountancy body, with more than 227 fully qualified members and 544 future members worldwide. MOU between CMA India and ACCA has expired on 19th February 2020. new MOU signing is pending for Union Cabinet approval. But still, the good news is that CMA India members can claim 9 exemptions in SCCA course, and they need to pass just 4 exams to become a member of SCCA. This could be the fast track route to global chartered accountancy qualification for CMA members. Then comes to CISI UK, the Chartered Institute for Securities and Investment, CISI UK, is the largest global professional body. For those who work in the financial and investment profession, CISI is the leading professional body for securities, investment, wealth, and financial planning professionals. CMA India and CISI signed a MOU on awarding the membership of CISI to CMA members and concessional fee for CMA students. It is very good news. Again, IP Australia, National Institute of Accountants, NIA Australia, is now known as IPA, Institute of Public Accountants Australia. It is one of the Australia's oldest representative professional bodies, formed over 97 years ago. It has over 40,000 students and members internationally. IP Australia and CMA India signed a memorandum of understanding on 9th March 2011 with a motive to achieve professional development for their students and members. And according to this MOU, it will create a harmonious, relation between the institutes to move forward globally in order to enable achieve optimum potential for the members of the profession in the international arena, and will recognize the profession and professional development programs offered by each institute. Then it is CIMA UK, the Chartered Institute of Management Accountants. CIMA is a UK-based professional body offering training and qualification in management accountancy and related subjects. It is focused on accountants working in industry and provides ongoing support and training for members. Although there is no MOU between CIMA UK and CMA India, CIMA UK offers exemptions for CMA students and members. In this regard, a CMA India final passed would get at least 12 of CIMA papers exempted, and only 6 papers need to pass to get CIMA qualification. While an associate member of CMA India needs to take only 1 paper, and that is strategic level case study paper, to get CIMA membership. However, in order to excel this exam, a student needs to study all 3 papers of strategic level. CIMA UK is a certification that can shape up a student's career in anywhere he goes, especially in Commonwealth countries. From the job perspective in Europe, one needs to have a credential recognition there. Now is the turn for question answers. I would request Mr. Sharma and Anshika, if there is any questions, please pass to me. Thank you.
think Sir Rohan has disconnected with us, so I'm going to ask a question on behalf of us. I think, am I audible to you?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Hello, am yes. I audible?
Yes, I can hear you.
Thank you, sir, for guiding us about all this qualification about and giving recognition of CMA degree in Europe. And now this time is for question and answers. So, to get a job in Europe.
Sorry, I missed your question. Can you please?
Hello.
Repeat. Can you please repeat the question?
I am asking ki how all these qualifications like MCSI, FIPA, FICCA, and all other qualifications which are discussed in this, how qualifications to get on Europe, European.
Rohan, your voice is breaking. I think I should ask a question on behalf of yourself.
Please.
Sir, please guide our viewers, or better, I say future CMAs and qualified CMAs, as how they can secure MCSI, FFA, FIPA, whatever the qualifications you are having, how they can get these qualifications, and what are the beneficial qualifications for them to get an excellent career path.
Thank you, Anshika. Yes. Very important question. Basically, affiliation or attachment with professional bodies have so many benefits which a professional should try to avail. But in practical, it is not always been possible for a professional to be affiliated with so many professional bodies because of various reasons. For example, as a future CMA or qualified CMA, if you are affiliated with professional bodies, you can avail educational opportunities, you can be certified, you can gain chance of accessing to resources, attending seminars, training, workshop, CPDs, networking opportunities, you can enjoy professional recognition, and you can enhance social responsibilities. And so many benefits are there which enable you to develop your career and have a better job.
Yeah.
Here, I have been asked about some designations. First one is CISI, is quite related, which I spoke with regard to MOU, Chartered Institute of Securities and Management. You, in order to get this qualification as a CMA member, you need to apply and you need to pass an integrity test that is for 40 minutes. Sometimes it's very difficult to get passed even for 3 months. But I passed in one chance. So their question pattern is some professional that if you go to their website, you'll find that they keep their questions making difficult. So it is around 35 to 40 minutes time test. And after, if you qualify that test, then they will offer you as a member, chartered member of Institute of for Securities and Investment. If you are a member of CMA India, otherwise you can't obtain this membership, this designation. And after obtaining this designation, if you continue their CPDs for 2 years, you can apply for fellow membership chartered securities and investment. And this is internationally recognized qualification. And in UK and other parts of the body, if you find it is recognized, valued. The website address is www.cisi.org. Then comes to IFA UK. As we discussed in our MOU, that IPA Australia has an MOU with CMA India. Similarly, IPA Australia and IFA UK are merged into one organization. And 2014 or 2015, I think, they merged. And if you are a member of IP Australia or if you are a member of IFA UK, you can obtain their qualification. And this is world's largest financial organization body, having UK. UK, even they are allowed to do accounts, audit works in UK. And they're well recognized, very. And their course, they offer their course also, I think it's 18 months course. As a CMA, India, you can easily do their course. It's very easy for you all. So I think it's better if you can, you should avail this chance. At the first of all, I think they will grant you associate membership. Then you can apply after 6 fellow membership. Their website address is www.ifa.org.uk. Okay. Then comes Institute of Public Accountants Australia, IPA. I told you it has already been, MOU with CMA India. You can easily get. Their qualification is also recognized because it is the in Australia's public finance, public accounting bodies. And then Institute, as I told you, if you are affiliated, if you are attached with so many organizations, it is better for you. Then Institute of Financial Consultants, I qualified in 2001 or 2. Then at that time, they used to take a course. They used to offer a course and take an exam of 3 hours on the basis of some papers were there, financial management, financial accounting, public finance, like this, 4 or 5 papers. Their syllabus, I don't know whether today is their syllabus, same syllabus. I think it has changed, syllabus has been changed. So it is also USA's recognized financial body. And you can obtain fellow membership. Their website address is ifconsultants.org. Then Chartered Institute of Business Administrators, CBA. Chartered BBA, this is also same. You can obtain, they offer short course. I think their course is very short. So if you just study a week or 10 days, you can easily pass. What I did in 2004, I think, 2004 or 2005. So it's very easy because, we are proud that our CMA Indias, they are very talented and they are very brilliant. They can easily do, they can easily pass and achieve these qualifications.
So thank you so much, sir, for sharing about the knowledge of all these courses. And I think the second question, a very important question, which is circulating in my mind again and again, I'm asking, going to ask that question. As you are also a non-UK citizen, as you are from the Bangladesh, so, and we all peoples who is getting connected in this session are also a UK non-UK citizen. So how you get, how you secured your job, so please share your experience so that we can also feel that, yes, we can easily get the job over there.
Thank you again. Very interesting question. I, along with my wife and children, arrived in the UK from Bangladesh in February 2007 under the British government's highly skilled migration program, HSMP. It was a great challenge for me at that time to secure a job. And believe it not, or don't know, I had to encounter much difficulties in this respect. I am a live dedicated member of Ahmadiyya Muslim Community UK and is currently serving as manager finance and accounts with Al Shirkatul Islamiyya, which is one of the largest charities in UK. Okay. Ahmadiyya Muslim Community are Muslims who believe in the Messiah, Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, peace be on him, 1835 to 1908 of Qadian, India, Gurdaspur. Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, peace be on him, founded the Ahmadiyya Muslim Community in 1889 as a revival movement within Islam highlighting its essential teachings of peace, love, justice, and purity of life. Today, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community is the world's fastest growing, largest Islamic community under one divine appointed leader, His Holiness Mirza Masroor Ahmad. May Allah be his helper. The Ahmadiyya Muslim community spans over 218 nations with membership exceeding tens of millions. Thank you.
Thank you so much. The next question I would like to ask on behalf of the students. One very interesting question I have seen in the comment section, that if a particular student is a CMA interqualified, so is it possible for them that they can get the job in European countries on the basis of CMA interqualification?
Basically, in this respect, I will tell you that CMA inter or fully doesn't matter. The matter is that in respect of CMA India's for experienced or freshers, UK practical experience is preferred always. If you apply to get a job, they will see whether you have UK experience or not. And in some cases, it is difficult to get a job if you don't have UK experience.
Okay. So, sir, as you said that we should have this UK experience. So, for getting the experience in UK, we need to get the job first. So, how is it possible to get the UK experience?
It is very easy. If you come to UK, if you migrate to UK, you can do part-time job with accounting firms. There are so many accounting firms out there. And as you are qualified, you are professional, you are well-versed to do any accounting job. You can prepare accounts, you can do bookkeeping works, any two. And within 6 months, within 6 months or like this period, you can get experience. And that experience is considered.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. It is very interesting question to know about how we can get the job in foreign countries. So I don't know who asked this question, but I thought you have also got your answer. So the next question I'm asking, what are the opportunities open for CMA experienced and freshers and salary offered?
As I told you already, that CMA, in respect of CMA India, for experienced and freshers, UK practical experience is always preferred.
Okay.
And in some cases, you cannot expect to have a job if you don't have UK experience. Salary, as I told you, depends upon your experience and contacts. Here, average basic salary, 20,000 to 30,000 for freshers, and 30,000 to 70,000 for experienced, as I told you.
So it's 20,000 or 30,000 or 70,000. Is it Indian rupees or in local currency of Europe?
Pounds, yearly. Pounds.
Okay.
Pound sterling. UK is pound sterling.
I think Rohan has also got connected with us. So this next
actually,
question.
I am also connected with you. I am listening.
Okay, so Rohan, I'll transfer the questions list to you, so you may ask the question.
Actually, here is some network problem. Because of this, I want to say you can continue.
Okay, sure. So, a question, very interesting question. Like, if we would like to get the job, and everyone wants that, if there is a vacancy of 10 people and there is a candidate of 100, there is 100 candidates, so everyone that I should get the job. So what should be the abilities in the to become a strong applicant?
Very good question. And you know, this question, the requirement of a prospect candidate is same almost all over. We know that a man of qualities is always admired and is desired by all. Naturally, being a CMA, you combine some rare qualities. Mainly, an applicant should have good communication knowledge, effective leadership and management ability, adaptability, maturity of a professional attitude. You should have analytical skills, teamwork, and interpersonal skills. You should have confidence. You should have reliance so that company can rely on you, and so many other, you know, characteristics and qualities are there.
Okay, so one more question also. As we know that when we get in the job, so we need to work on some softwares. Like nowadays, SAP and MS Excel is the worldwide. So we need to work. We need to have the knowledge of MS Excel and as SAP also. So is there any other like interesting softwares where we on which we need to work in UK especially?
Yes.
Like in India, there is a Tally.
A very good question. In UK, we use SageLine 50.
Sorry, sir?
SageLine 50, SAGE, SageLine 50. There is an accounting software. It is widely used for small businesses. And there is also one for, that is something, you know, QuickBooks. Okay. So these two softwares are widely used for accounting purposes.
Okay, so anyone who is interesting to go to the Europe and would like to get the work in the accounting, so I ask this question on behalf of yourself. So you guys need to prepare or need to learn these two softwares if you would like to work in there or get the job easily in European countries. So the next question is, how Indian CMA can get job in London and how should we apply for the jobs?
Basically, Indian CMA doesn't matter. Any CMA or any qualified can apply from there, but you have to have, as I told you, work experience, UK experience. You can apply, but they will put conditions on you that if you come, you have to be here, you have to gather 5 or 6 months experience or 1 year experience, then they will see you can work here or not. Because the environment, as I told you, is different. Things are same. Accounting works are same. But such as just I told you about the software. In Bangladesh, in India, and in other parts of the country, we use different softwares. But in UK, different software are used. So if we are not well versed of that software, of that working environment, of that culture, we cannot work. So this is the main thing, that we need to have experience of UK environment.
Okay. Sir, is there any portal from where we can apply? Like in India, Naukri.com is a portal from where we can apply for the jobs. So is there any portal for applying the jobs in UK?
Yes, there's so many recognized portals are there. Of them, there Total Jobs, CV Library, read.co.uk, Monster UK, Work in Startups, Unicorn Hunt, Otta, Azuna. These are recognized portals through which you will find so many jobs are there every day. Every day they are updating.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. It's very useful information for the guys who would like to get the job. So the next question I would like to ask, how the working environment is different, working environment and working culture is different from, how is the working environment? Just need to ask this question.
It's a very important question, working environment. It's really different, yes. Work environment or work culture in UK is different from other parts from various angles. Let's take the example of India versus UK. Here, one of the core differences between Indian and UK workplace environment is that senior managers in UK organizations don't essentially expect to call you sir or miss. In UK, businesses one needs to show respect to every colleague, irrespective of their job, title, and age. Unlike India, it's not always the case that elder people have the most power in the workplace. Someone who is younger than you could be your manager. UK offices are generally softer and more focused on work. But that's not the say that you can't get distracted with a little light and socializing here and there. Normally, a work day in the UK starts at 9 a.m. and finishes at 5 p.m. with some workers even facing disciplinary action or repetitive lateness. Meetings usually start on time and run like clockwork. The work-life balance is more noticeable in the UK, with many employees working hard during the day. Then the living in office and not taking any work home with them. In the UK, there's also a vast emphasis on making sure workers are taking care of normal mental and emotional health while at work, not just their physical health. Apart from these, some other differences are also there.
Okay, thank you, sir. So next one question was also as we know that there might be some geographical bias difference. Like if there is a vacancy of 10 candidates and there are 100 candidates of UK and the 10 candidates of Indian citizen. So is there any biasness that the UK's peoples will give the preference to the UK one and will not give the preference to the Indian citizens? Is there any biasness over there?
No. That is the good thing. This is the good thing. They are very much fair. They consider your qualification. They consider your smartness. They consider your ability. It's no unfairness. It's a very good thing.
Sounds good. We can get the equal opportunity.
But I can assure you, everywhere I've seen, everywhere, you will get, you will be cooperated, you will be supported in all respect from them.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. So, anything you would like to share? All these questions. Anything if you would like to share, you can please add on that too in this session. Or now I would like to invite the Rohan again. So Rohan, that's the list completion of list of questions from my side. If any of the questions you would like to ask, you can continue. So anything, if something interested you would like to share?
No, I don't have anything. It's up to you. You can ask.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah, you are audible.
So just one question is left. According to me, how we get a visa for European countries?
Yeah,
if I want to do job there,
it's an important question. Very important question. Basically, getting a visa, work visa, depends on the UK government's various programs and policies. Say, if I tell you my perspective, I got visa, as I mentioned, as highly skilled migration program. At that time, UK government used to have a program for those who are qualified, those who are experienced, those who are skilled, they can apply. I applied, I came to this country, but as I mentioned, it was difficult for me to get a job here because I did not have UK experience. So time to time, government changes policy. If you find the website, Home Office website, you can see that changes during last 1 year, so many changes are there, have been government has announced for the visa policies. There are certain requirements, terms and conditions upon which Home Office issues visa. When Home Office is satisfied with the applicant's procedures for work visa, they will grant you visa. So it depends upon what type of visa you are applying for. Are you applying for travel visa? Are you applying for visit visa? Are you applying for study visa? Are you applying for work visa? It depends.
Nothing left to me also.
Sir, one question I would like to ask is, like, as I'm applying from India, and there is a company in the UK who is interested to get hired me. So is there any process that the on the basis of the company visa, like a company should
apply for visa for you?
For me and
yes, very good question. I know it is. Yes, there is option. It's very good sign. If you have any opportunities that Indian company UK based in UK, if they want to hire you, it's very easy. It will be very easy. It can be done, and it makes the applicants process easier, very much easier. It happens. And I brought some friends. They came under this process from Bangladesh to UK.
So it was very interesting question, very knowledgeable session. Thank you so much, sir, for getting connected with us and guiding us on each and every topic very clearly.
And thank you so much, both of you, both Mr. Sharma, CMA, and Anshika. So thank you so much. It was really enjoyable. And thank you so much for arranging. I hope this would help the CMA students and members. Thank you.
Definitely, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye. Take care, and hope so you all well after taking the vaccine.
Thank you. Please stay safe and stay well. Thank you.
Sir, in future also, we would like to connect with you. So please stay with us.
And just give me 2 weeks' time. I think it would be better for me.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Bye.
It's really great pleasure.
Okay. Thank you so much, everyone. I would like to thank all of you who is connected with us. Thank you so much. Any of the question, not more than any other questions, whatever the questions asked in the comment section, we have already answered in the webinar. So if any other question is there, you may comment your questions in the comment section. I or Rohan will try to reply all of the questions. Thank you so much for joining this session.
Bye. Take care.
Okay. Bye. 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 Bye, sir.
Bye.